So now that we know how to do multiplication, let's go back and revisit fraction addition. So suppose I asked you to add these fractions. Remember, before we showed you, unless you make common denominator, we cannot add fractions. So to make common denominator, then we're going to use equivalent fractions. So you have this denominator and this denominator. And before we saw that unless you multiply numerator denominator using equivalent fractions so that they both have the same denominator, we cannot really add. So we're saying take this denominator, multiply numerator denominator of this term by it, take this fraction, multiply top and bottom by this denominator x. Now they both have the same denominator, so all we have to do now is this is the 2x. Use multiplication, distributes over addition. 4 times 3 is 12, and 4 times 4x is 16x, and then add like terms. So we have 18x plus 12 divided by this denominator. And so that would be how you add fractions. So when you learn a new concept, you see if we can now solve a problem from before that perhaps we were stuck on. All right, try this one on your own. I'll give you a few moments. Remember, these are two different denominators, right? So remember what we said. So this one would have to have 1 plus a in it, and this one would have to have 3 plus a in it. So as long as you keep equivalent fractions, you're able to do that. So now go ahead and multiply. This will be good practice for you. Use the distributive property. 1 times 1 is 1, 1 times a is a. 2 times 3 is 6, 2 times a is 2a. Now add like terms. Go ahead. So the final answer would be 7 plus 3a divided by 1 plus a times 3 plus a. This is very, very important and is going to really, really help if you go step by step and understand all the steps. So when you have common denominator, then we can continue adding the numerators. But unless you have common denominator, you cannot add fractions, whether they are algebraic fractions or numeric fractions. All right, we'll pause the video here, do this problem on your own, and then check your answer. It's very important that you do that so that the video log questions will be something you can do. Pause the video here, attempt the question, see what you got. Okay, so this one needs the 2x plus 3, this one needs 2 plus x, and then use distributive property and multiply. Add like terms. And that's your answer. Okay, do that one on your own now. Pause the video. And then add like terms. Remember now, here we had 2x times 3, 6x, 2x times 4x, 8x squared, because x times x. 1 times 3 is 3, 1 times 4x is 4x. And now add like terms. So 3x squared and 8x squared will give me 11x squared. 6x plus 6x, 12x plus 14x will give me 16x. And then 3 will be as is 3. Next set of video logs.